Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. My name is Emma and today I'm going to show you a quick and easy editing tip that you can use in your landscape photos. Now, to be honest with you guys, this is a pretty simple tip and I think that a lot of you may know it already. But I'm a little bit behind where I would like to be in my filming and editing process, and I didn't want to rush any of my other ideas and put them out before they're really as good as they could be. So I decided to just kind of keep things simple this week with a nice, easy editing tip video. So here's an image from my last photo shoot, and I didn't mention it at the time, but this is actually a composite of two photos. Both were taken at the same spot with the camera locked off on the tripod, but they were under slightly different lighting conditions. In this photo, the light is very nice, but it's just not that interesting in the foreground because the sun was behind the clouds the whole time. It's not really bad. This could be a great photo, I think, but I liked the foreground a little bit better in the second photo. This photo has sort of nice dappled light in the foreground, which I think makes it much more interesting. The problem, of course, is that when the sun came out to put that light in the foreground, it really kind of washed out the top portion of the photograph. The solution to this is to just really quickly combine these two photos into one image, and I will show you how to do that in just a second. But before I do, I want to mention a couple conditions that do have to be met in camera for this editing tip to work. Both of them are really kind of obvious, but the first is that the camera needs to stay really still the whole time, and then the second is that the subject and everything else in the photo also need to stay really still. So this is where having a tripod can be very helpful in your landscape photography, even if you're not actually using a slower shutter speed for longer exposures, and so you wouldn't really need the tripod to keep the camera steady enough for a sharp photo, because it gives you the ability to take multiple photos that are framed in exactly the same way. And then you'll also need for everything in the photo to be staying in the same spot. So if you're taking a picture of a moving subject, obviously, or if there's a lot of wind blowing, that could be moving around trees and grasses and things in your image. And so you need everything to be still for this to really work. So that's really the challenge of this type of a photo edit, is that you actually need a couple conditions to be met in camera, which is a little unusual for a photo editing technique. Alright, so now I'll spin around to the computer here though and just show you what we'll do to edit these two images together really very easily. Okay, and once again, I will be using Affinity Photo for this editing because that is my primary photo editor, and something that I'm really comfortable using and really like using. First thing that I will do is just open up the two raw files here and then make a couple of minor adjustments to them with the sharpening and denoising. And as I do this, I'm going to kind of look primarily at the portion of the image that I know I'm going to want to be keeping, because the part that I'm going to hide obviously just doesn't really matter that much. So basically, I'm just using the clarity, detail refinement, and denoise adjustments here. Kind of somewhat arbitrarily adding clarity and detail refinement until things look sharp to me, zooming in a little bit, taking a look at them, and removing any noise that I see. Now that I've got that done, I'm going to go ahead and hit the develop button on both of these photos, which is just going to solidify these edits to the initial raw file. Now, the way that I have Affinity Photos set up, it's not really reducing the amount of data. There's no compression happening at this point. It's just finalizing some edits, and everything after this will be maintained as a live edit that I could go back and change. Now that I have done that, what I'm going to do is just copy and paste one of these on top of the other one. Okay, and you can see now I've got both images here in one file as two separate layers. So if I were to hide this layer, you can see the other image is available to me underneath. And what I'll do is just add a mask onto the top layer, select that mask, take a gradient filter, and drag it over it. And you can see that the black portion here is the part that is being hidden, and the white portion is the part that is being kept. And so we just want to set it up something like this. It doesn't actually need to be a particularly long gradient, but we can just adjust it till it looks right. Something like that. And then what we can actually do is refine this mask a little bit using the brush tool as well. So if I take the black brush here and mouse over some of these areas, you can see the lighting kind of changing a bit. And I can just pick out specific areas that I think look better underneath. So this rock here, for example, has a little bit of light on it that isn't really shown with my regular gradient filter, as well as up into the water right here in the front. Think looks a little bit nicer in that other photo. So if I take the mask off and back on, there's of course what that looks like, the photo underneath of it. Now at this point is when I'm going to apply my color editing to the photo. I could have done this editing before in the developer personas and then combined the color edited images together. But I think it's just a little bit easier to see if you combine the images first. And at this point, I'm able to add color adjustments to the overall image with both photos combined, or to specific photos to adjust the top or bottom portions of the image. So the first thing that I'll do here is just take an HSL layer, add it on top, and just saturate the overall image more, and we'll go up about here on that and saturate the reds more as well, because there's some nice red trees in there, not too far, but maybe something like that. And you can see that applies throughout the image, both to the top and bottom portions. But then if I wanted to apply an adjustment to just one part of the image, I can add this and add it, for example, just to the top part of the image by dropping it, drag and dropping it underneath of that layer. And you can see now if I were to, say, change the saturation a whole lot, that's just applying to the top. So what we can do now is come up just a little more on our overall saturation. We can give it a bit more of the red, and we can make some adjustments to the greens, maybe saturate them just a little bit more and change their hue a little bit so that they look a little greener, and bring up their saturation some more like that. A lot of times I will change the green color of some of the greens in the photo to something I find more appealing. We can also add more contrast on the top section here. I think that would be really helpful. So we'll drop that on there. Really makes these trees stand out from one another a lot more than they did. Makes them a little bit less flat looking. To the lower portion of the photo, I think we will add a bit of white balance. And not a whole lot here, but I'm just gonna make it very slightly yellower because the top portion is a little yellower than the bottom. So just something like that. It's a very, very subtle difference. You might have a hard time even seeing it in the video. and then I will add a final HSL adjustment on the bottom portion of the image as well, which I think we will do some overall saturation on, then some additional green saturation as well. The greens being in the mosses here throughout these rocks. I think that's actually a little much on the green. Come back just a bit, like that. So all of those color adjustments then are pretty easy to apply to different portions of the photo and see what your overall result is looking like once you've got the two pieces of it put together. But it's really easy to take a couple of photos and use a gradient mask like that to select portions of the photo that you think look really good, as well as just to use a brushed on mask. You could have done that for the whole thing, or if you had several different photos you wanted to work with, and certainly to refine that gradient mask as well, just kind of pick certain areas, just use a real soft black or white brush on that mask. And it's very easy to combine your photos like that, make specific adjustments to the portions, and end up with something that really has the best light from each of the photos. Alright, so that's all for this video. Just a really simple editing trick, although a fairly powerful one that you can use in landscape photos and really in other types of photos as well, when you have different lights that you want to combine together. So that is going to be all for this video, guys. I do have some more exciting things planned for the future, and some time off of work coming up that I'm hoping to be able to use to implement some of those exciting ideas that I have for you guys. But until then, if you did like this video, don't forget to hit the like button on your way out and to subscribe to my channel. As always, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.